People, que pasa? What they do? Now the first thing that is popping in the dancehall landscape, we see that the six, we are speaking about squash, we are speaking about Chronicla, but specifically in this case, we see that Daddy One is getting a bashing from Ari FM because they claim that he was a no-show once again, one more again. Now people, we see that this is a bad reflection on the six, and we see that the six, we are talking about squash, we are talking about Chronicla, and now Daddy One, we see that they are having a bad reputation for not showing up for booked events. And according to the person that were doing the interview, or that was on Ari FM, they said that they called his manager. I think we're speaking about Heavy D from Supreme Promotion. And they confirmed not only once, twice, three times, four times, five times, whatever amount of time, and they did not show up. And according to the report, it is said that Daddy One claimed that he was there, he was on his way to the location, he was on his way to perform when he basically buck up in an accident on the street. Now people, we have to remember that we live in an information age. That means if Daddy One use an excuse and claims him did dip on him way and he buck up in an accident, anybody can go up on social media, anybody can Google and find out what sorts of accident were on the way from Montego Bay to Ochi or Negril or whatever, from Portland, Raete and Lele. It is easy information that is accessible, especially when we are speaking about Ari FM that have the latest technology. So anyway, they say that he was lying. Basically, that is the moral, or that is the gist of what they were saying on the interview. Now when we think about the situation, we have to remember that Ari FM is one of the biggest radio stations in the whole of Jamaica, if not the biggest. And when we also look at it, we have to also remember that Ari FM is also a part of Zip FM. So we are talking about two of the major radio stations in Jamaica. So therefore, you don't want to be blacklisted by any of these radio stations, because we are speaking about when people are promote you. We are talking about when an artist, we are talking about like the six them, when them get the big break, because we have to remember that there are hundreds or even thousands of artists out there that is looking for a big break, that is looking for fame and fortune. So therefore, when you get an opportunity, when a media house like Ari FM book you, you do not want to be late, you do not want to be missing, you do not want to be a no-show, because it is a bad reflection on the whole group. We are talking about Chronicla, we are talking about Squash, we are talking about Daddy One, and we are also speaking about their management. Now when we talk about the management for the six, we are talking about Heavy D, we are talking about Leng, we are talking about Supreme Promotion. And we see that they might have some links. We see that they have an idea of how to manage artists. We see that when artists are young and new in the business, they are kind of desperate. So therefore, they will gravitate to person that they feel can help them. But based on the track record of Supreme Promotion, Heavy D, we see that they also manage Gully Bop, and we know what happened there. We saw that they also managed Tommy Lee Sparta, and that was a time when Tommy Lee Sparta was getting the most bashing from the popo. And we have to also remember that Leng is an ex-popo. So therefore, if he could not have helped Tommy Lee Sparta, then I don't know who he is going to help. So my point is that we see that they managed Tommy Lee Sparta, that did not work out. They managed Shauna Chin, that did not really work out. And they also managed Gully Bop, and now they are responsible for the six. And I am speaking specifically Heavy D, because I am not sure what type of role that Leng plays in the management of these artists. However, I know that Heavy D is the person that is mostly responsible for the six. We are talking about specifically Squash, we are talking about Chronicla, and we're also speaking about Daddy One. So we see that they have some link, but I don't think that they are proper management. I don't think that they are very professional. And even if they are, it seems like these artists, them don't listen to their manager, they don't listen to their PR team, because they have a bad reputation. And we are talking about These are some artists that just basically bust in the last year or two. So my point is that we see so many instances where these persons from this group we are talking about, the six, have a bad reputation for not showing up, are just missing point blank and period. And people like me say, sometimes we can't even blame the management because the management don't really have any power. Them can't tell them artists what to do. Because sometimes as soon as the artists them bust them non take no chat. And that is why a lot of times you see these artists with a lot of yes men around them, because they don't like constructive criticism. They don't like to follow rules and regulation. Them just want people to tell them, say, yeah, you are this and you are that and you are the best and rate and lele. But people, at the end of the day, it is a recipe for destruction. It is a recipe for disaster. And that is what is mashing up dancehall, because we see that most of these artists, and I am not saying that this applies to the six, I am just speaking in general. We see that a lot of these artists, them don't listen, they are hot-headed, and them just want things their own way, them too hype, them too gas up. And like me say, the higher the monkey climb is, the more that he is going to get exposed. And it is only going to be to the detriment of dancehall and those specific artists. And like we see people, this is not a recipe for success, and that is why we see a lot of these new dancehall artists. They are not getting the success, they are not getting the international collaboration that they should want or that they need, because people overseas see that they are very indisciplined, and people don't want to work with people that are not responsible. Because at the end of the day, when these persons are going to spend their money to promote, these artists might not even show up. And most of the time, when you see an artist give a lot of trouble, then you know that they are going to lose their visa, and people can't do nothing with them when they're stuck at Jamaica, point blank and period. So based on what the people in my IRA FM is saying, they are even questioning the performance, the live performances of the six. We are talking about Squash, we are talking about Chronicler, and we are even speaking about Daddy One. People are putting up question signs and asking the question, is the six gun shy? Is the six not showing up at these events because they realize that people are saying that them can't perform? People are saying that the songs are bigger than the artists. People are saying that these artists are some studio artists. So people, let me know what you think in the comment section. Do you think that the songs are bigger than these artists? Do you think that these artists are in the studio with the engineers and the producer and they are doctoring up the song? So therefore, when the artists go up on stage and they are supposed to perform the song, them can't produce or they cannot reproduce what we hear on the radio. People, let me know in the comment section if the artists, and we are talking about Squash, we are talking about Chronicler, and we are also speaking about Daddy One. Are these artists sounding the same on stage? Are they performing up to par based on the hit songs that they have on the radio? Let me know what you think in the comment section. And the people them on the radio station is also saying that the six is asking for a high booking fee. And people, like we see, if the price is high, that means that the performance supposed to be high. That means that the artist cannot be only a bunch of hype and a bunch of hot air. The artist have to be able to perform on stage and make the people them feel the song. Because people, the truth and the fact is that as a fan of any dancehall artist, we like to hear their songs on the radio. We like to listen to them song on CDs and Rete and Lele. However, we want to see them on stage and performing just like it sounds on the radio. We want to see them kind of amp up their performance. So therefore, when an artist have a big song and then them go up on the stage and them daddy, them act like them have dropsy, them act like them want to sleep, people, it is a bad reflection to dancehall. It is a bad reflection on these artists. So like me say, the six, me I talk about Squash, me I talk about Chronicler, me I talk about Daddy One. You need to fix up on the act. Me I talk about the management, me I talk about every day. You need to straighten up the artists, because right now, they're reputation is very stink out there in the dancehall space, point blank and period. So anyways, people, like me say, it is just my views and opinion. It is not the gospel. Your views and opinion can be respectfully different from mine, but let me know what you think in the comment section. So the next thing that is popping in the entertainment space that we see, that legendary sprinter we are speaking about, Usain Bolt, was indirectly involved in a brawl in London. Now, people, it was said that he was attending an event for a reality show called Love Island,
where one of the members or the members were promoting their new clothing line when they got into an altercation or a verbal altercation with about 7 men from Eastern Europe. Now, people, when we speak about Eastern Europe, it is said, or I am just speaking in general, that they are very prejudiced, and also they like to drink, and also they like to get involved in a brawl. Now, people, like I said before, I don't know who started the brawl or who initiated the brawl, but you know that Usain Bolt is the most famous person on any block. So, therefore, his name is always going to be called. So, people, like me say, I don't know if his friends, his direct friends, or just some associates got into a brawl, or because he was among some black men, they are always going to say that it was Usain Bolt's crew and Rete and Lele. It was also said that no one was hurt or no one was arrested during the whole incident or the whole altercation. And when we think about the name Usain Bolt, we know that it is a name that is an actual brand. It is a name that is affiliated with nothing but professionalism, because he always represents himself well. He always represents Jamaica well. And we also know that he is a global ambassador. We are speaking about for Puma. We are speaking about a lot of liquors, and we are also speaking about other apparel brands. So we know that he is not going to do anything to jeopardize his whole name and his characteristics, point blank and period. So anyways, people, that is my views on the whole thing as it pertains to that. And like me say, it is just my views and opinion. It is not the gospel. Your views and opinion can be respectfully different from mine. But let me know what you think in the comment section. Bless up.